The rate at which Cabinet is overturning Parliament resolutions recently has forced members of Parliament to raise eyebrows on the possible rift that is escalating between the legislature and executive. Last week, the President ordered reinstatement of the Permanent Secretary of the Minister of Trade, Geraldine Sally, as the accounting officer of the ministry, despite a resolution of Parliament that recommended her sacking. This was made worse by the IGG, who dropped charges against former UNBS boss David Livingstone Ebiru, who was implicated by the Parliamentary Committee of Kosase, which saw MPs registering their disapproval. Now, senior legislators have urged the Speaker of Parliament and the top leadership of the House to seek an audience with the President to iron out issues which are causing disagreements between the two organs of government.
There must be a discussion between the leadership of Parliament and the office of the President. There must be a discussion, because if it continues, then there is no need of Parliament actually taking such investigating, because we cannot spend taxpayers' money investigating, and reports are made, decisions are made, recommendations are made, and they are ignored.
We have met the President on several occasions, but the context might be different. One of the facts I've appreciated is he brings his argument out whenever he throws out a recommendation, and he brings his part of the story. The spirit in which he brings the part of the story, he wants us to amalgamate and come into a consensus. Now, we are waiting for the recommendation that's thrown out. Under what context did he throw out the recommendations?
The 11th Parliament has in different reports recommended to ministers Monica Msenero of Science, Technology and Innovation and Betty Amongi for Gender, Labour and Social Development to resign after being implicated in different scandals, but the two have paid deaf ears. Also, Persis Namuganza, who was censured by Parliament in January this year, has remained in office as if nothing happened and no action was taken by the appointing authority.
I think this regime has to step up in terms of respecting resolutions of Parliament. There have been reports, and those reports, first of all, about Geraldine Sally, a report of Parliament, and about a bill, a report of Parliament. So it is about the impunity of this regime. At the end of the day, it's about the impunity.
Lawmakers believe Parliament has been ridiculed enough in the eyes of the public, and thus calling for harmony between the House and the executive.
Government works in systems, and in the event that any chain breaks from the system collapses. I don't think and I don't feel it will be in good faith for 11th Parliament to break away from the chain. We are trying to hold a unity in this country, and the unity, there's nowhere better this unity can be held by keeping us joined together with the executive, the judiciary, and the legislature. So one, me being a diplomatic person, I wouldn't see us breaking away or opposing, but then doesn't stop us from questioning.
Notably, resolutions or recommendations of Parliament are merely advisory. The executive can use its direction to either adopt or dismiss these resolutions, save for those direct by the constitution and financial resolutions. However, organs of government are bound to respect each other while performing roles in accordance with the constitution. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the News at Parliament.